could have fires, but she wants to know, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, that's a very good question, Dorothy. Oh, maybe we should ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Shake sounds just like a fire engine. Very good, Shake. Now go up, please. Thank you, Shake. Oh, look! It's Mr. Noodle's sister, Miss Noodle. Hi, Miss Noodle. Hi. Oh, Miss Noodle. Wow. Miss Noodle is really good at spinning. Oh. Boy, but she sure needs to work on stopping. Miss Noodle. Miss Noodle. Are you there? Oh. There you are. Hi, Miss Noodle. Boy, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, she knows. Miss Noodle.
No, that's not right.
Hey, that's a football uniform.
That's for football, not for fighting fires.
Yeah, that's what football players wear, Miss Noodle.
You can't fight a fire in that. That's what football players wear to keep safe.
And it really works.
Try again, Miss Noodle.
What do firefighters wear to keep safe?
No!
That's a suit of armor. You can't fight a fire in that. That's what knights wear to keep safe.
What do firefighters wear?
No, they don't wear armor. No.
Try again, Miss Noodle.
You can do it.
Try again.
Whoa. Careful, Miss Noodle.
Yay!
Yeah, that's right.
That's a firefighter's uniform. Miss Noodle is pretending to put out a fire.
What's wrong, Miss Noodle?
But there's no water coming out.
No water?
Oh.
Where's the water?
Where's the water? Boy, those noodles are very good at getting wet. Yeah, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires?
Dorothy, see these gloves? Firefighters wear them so their hands don't get burnt.
Hey, Dorothy, see this coat? This coat protects firefighters from getting wet or getting burnt. Yeah, it does feel kind of heavy. It's about 5 pounds.
Hi, Dorothy. Firefighters wear these boots when they put out fires to keep their feet from getting wet or burned.
Thank you, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask our baby. Oh, hello, baby. Baby, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, yeah, a helmet to keep their heads from getting hurt. Oh, thank you, baby. And now... to put out a fire. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, yeah. And now, Elmo has a question for you. How many firefighters are in this fire truck? Let's count them and see. Fire truck!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
12 firefighters in a fire truck! Oh, boy. And one big elephant hose. Oh, great counting, everybody. And now...
Elmo has mail.
Hold it. Hold it. Slow
Elmo
down, computer.
Mail.
Where's the fire?
Elmo has mail.
Hey, no. Stop, computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
At last, Elmo can get his email. Oh boy, Elmo got email from his friend Oscar.
Hey, Elmo, since I don't help whenever I can, this email is not about firefighters. It's about the toast I'm making. It's gonna be just the way I like it. burnt. Yum.
Trash can on fire!
Stand back, please, sir.
Okay, we got a hot trash can here.
Hey.
Oh, don't touch the can, please, sir. You might get burned.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Turn on the water.
Get the water.
Turn on the water.
Okay, the fire's out.
Okay, it's safe now, sir.
Yeah.
You can return to your trash can. Mm-hmm.
What's the big idea?
Have a nice day.
You ruined my burnt toast. Now it's all wet and soggy. Wet and soggy burnt toast? Mmm, delicious. And that's my email about burnt toast, Elmo. Hey, wait a minute. It was about firefighters too, wasn't it? Oh, phooey.
Thanks for the email, computer. Wow. Hot trash cans can burn you. Let's find out what else can burn you. Oh, Drawer. There you are. Drawer's not hot. It won't burn down, Mom. Okay, Drawer, open up. No, open up, Drawer. No. Stay. Don't come with Elmo. Just open up, please. Oh, boy. Drawer's supposed to open. Can birthday cakes burn you?
No. But the candles on the birthday cake can.
Blow them out quick. Very good. Can stoves burn you?
Yes. Don't touch stoves.
Can bowls burn you?
No.
Unless there's hot porridge in them.
Don't touch it, baby bear.
Come on, porridge, get cool.
I'll help. I'll huff and I'll puff.
Not me, the porridge!
Ooh, porridge.
Elmo's friend Sabrina knows that fire can burn you. That's why she practices what to do in case there's a fire in her house. And Sabrina told Elmo all about it. Oh, you want to watch too, Drawer? Okay. Go ahead, Sabrina.
Lots of times, my mom, dad, and I have a fire drill. That's when we practice getting out of our apartment, the way we would in a real fire. My mom makes sure I know where we can meet. First, I get low and go. You're supposed to do that. Because if there's a fire, there's smoke, and you have to get below the smoke. I meet my mom where we said we'd meet. I'm happy to see her. My mom touches the door to make sure it's not hot, and there is no fire outside the door. I know the safe ways out of my apartment. My dad is practicing using the fire escape. We know where to meet him outside. My mom and I go down the hallway and walk down the stairs. We still have to stay low. Then we go outside. When we get outside, we meet my dad at the corner. That's our safe place to meet. In a real fire, we would stay out until the firefighters tell us when to go back inside. But this isn't a real fire, so we can go back inside now. I'm glad we have fire drills. Now I know what to do in case of a real fire. And I feel a lot safer.
Aw, thanks, Sabrina. Oh, that gives them an idea. Elmo's gonna practice how to get low and go. You wanna practice with Elmo? Oh, good. Okay, let's get low. Are you low? Okay, now let's go. Hey, hey, hey! Come back, come back! There you are! Okay, okay, that was great. But now, Elmo wants to learn more about firefighters, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, look! The TV is practicing how to get low. Oh, and go! Wait, wait, wait! Come back! Come back, TV! Elmo wants to see the firefighter channel. Good, now turn yourself on.
The Firefighters Channel. All firefighters all the time. The channel that's really hot. Today, Mike, the firefighting dog.
One day, Mike, the firefighting dog, was eating his dinner in his firehouse when all of a sudden, the fire alarm sounded. That meant there was a fire to fight. Mike slid down the fire pole and in a jiffy put on his special firefighting clothes to protect him from the fire and his helmet to keep his head from getting hurt. Then he rushed to the fire. When he got to the fire, he heard barking coming from inside the house. So Mike put on his air tank and mask to keep from breathing in smoke and went into the burning house. He pulled a young pup from the flames and then put out the fire. It was all in a day's work for Mike, the firefighting dog. The end. The firefighting dog. The end. Or is it?
Look, Mikey's dreaming again.
Dreaming about chasing cats, Mikey?
Time to go fight a fire.
Watch the firehouse for us, Mikey.
Now it's the end.
Coming up next on the Firefighters Channel, The Flaming of the Shrew, starring Carol Burnett.
Thanks, TV. But wait, 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 TV. Elmo wants to know more. Oh, no. TV is still practicing. But Elmo still wants to know more about firefighters. How can we find out more? Who could that be? Come in.
Want to talk to a firefighter?
Oh, boy. Elmo can talk to his friend, Firefighter Richard. Yay!
Don't forget us.
Oh, yeah. Elmo can talk to everybody.
So what do you want to know, Elmo?
Well, Elmo thinks fires are scary.
They are scary.
Oh yeah, very scary.
Is it scary being a firefighter?
Sure.
Oh yeah, sure. Very scary.
But I take care of myself, so it's okay. I wear these special clothes that help keep me safe.
Oh yeah, special clothes.
Elmo knows all about the boots and the coat and the helmet.
And I'm part of a team of firefighters. We work together and help keep each other safe.
Oh, a team. Ooh, like a soccer team?
Yeah, sort of.
Oh yeah, we're a team. We're buddies. Hi, buddy.
Hi.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a firefighter.
Oh yeah, firefighter.
Yeah. Elmo is ready to fight a fire.
Firefighters don't only fight fires.
Really?
We also help animals.
Meow. Oh, a kitty needs help. Firefighter Elmo is on the way. Meow. Hello, kitty.
Meow.
Here, kitty, kitty, kitty. You're safe now, kitty. Take us down, Justin. Whee!
Firefighters help people who get hurt, too.
Firefighter Elmo will help. Much better. Thanks, Firefighter Elmo. Just doing Firefighter Elmo's job. Firefighter Richard must really like being a firefighter.
I wouldn't want to do anything else.
Oh yeah, nothing else.
Well, I better get going. It's time for me to go home and cook dinner for my kids.
Firefighter Richard is a daddy, too? Wow, firefighters are amazing.
Oh yeah, amazing.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye, buddy.
Bye, firefighter, Richard.
Thanks. Elmo really loves firefighters. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the firefighter song. Yay!
Yay! Yay!
My great buddy, Hero Guy. And look, a wee little kitten up in a tree. Hey, Hero Guy, what's doing?
What's doing? You drew a picture of a kitten up in a tree.
Yeah, so?
So, now it wants to come down from the tree and doesn't know how.
Well, so help her down.
But you drew it. You're the artist.
But you're the superhero.
Good point. So let me get back into the picture and solve this problem with the kitty.
As well you should, Mr. Superhero Guy. Oh, the poor little kitty does want to come down.
That's right. And I, Hero Guy, just thought of a super way to solve this problem. I will fly to the top of the tree and carry the kitty down myself. Watch! Come on, kitty! Ew, little kitty, kitty, kitty!
Meow, meow, meow!
Come on, kitty! Ew, little kitty, kitty, kitty!
Meow, meow, meow!
She doesn't seem to want to go with me. What's the matter?
I don't know. I guess she's not used to seeing people, you know, like, fly around trees. I think flying around like that scares her.
Oh. But I'm a hero. I'm supposed to save her, not scare her.
That's true.
I will not give up. I will find a super way to get this kitty out of the tree right now. I know. I will turn myself into a trampoline. Watch this. Ta-da!
Good work, Hero Guy. Okay, kitty. Okay, now come on. Come on, jump onto the trampoline. It's very bouncy. Yeah, and you'll be able to bounce on it, and then you'll come down. I think she bounced a little too hard.
As a hero guy, I have failed. I tried to get the kitty out of the tree, but I couldn't do it.
No. Come on, hero guy. I drew you, so I know you can do it. You know, you can't always solve a problem right away, you know? Sometimes it takes time, you know, to find the right strategy, you know? The right steps, yeah, to solve the problem.
Steps? Steps? That's it!
Hey! Elmo guy! I knew you could do it! Come on, little kitten. Come on, walk down those heroic steps! You did it!
Give me paw! Go!
And so ends another brave, yet true, adventure with Hero Guy. What a hero! What a guy!